Hey everyone, Erin Stoney here. Well, you asked for some clean and press cueing tips for our kettlebell combine format, and I have a few for you. If you haven't yet seen the live on air class that we filmed last week, go ahead and head over to the bank and check that out as well. I put in a clean and press just so you guys could hear some of the cues that come out of this wild and crazy mouth. First thing you want to do with a clean and press situation is make sure that your members have flipped their fancy Apple watches and Garmin watches over so that the top of the wrist is free to have a kettlebell on it. You can do that at the beginning of class during your introduction. Next thing to note is you're picking up that kettlebell. Your clean is actually an upright row with some power behind it. And then the kettlebell is going to rotate around your wrist. So it's going to look like this to get into this position. We simply rotate it to get it to the back side of the wrist here. It's kind of like when you're taking your purse and you're flipping it over your shoulder so you can go shopping. Or another thing to think about is it's like the moon orbiting around the earth. It goes around instead of a flip, okay? That's just gonna hurt our members. That's an advanced move, and if you're doing that in your own training, that's cool. But when we're in the group fitness studio, let's do this corkscrew version of the clean and press. So we pull it up, spin it around, settle in for just a split second, and then go into our press. Our press is a full lockout with a nice straight arm. You should be able to walk around like this all day. It doesn't take a lot of energy because your joints are locked. And then you just reverse it, bring it down, unwind, and come back down. Flip it around, settle in, then a slight push press, okay? So you're also gonna want your members to pick up a heavy enough kettlebell that a push press is where they go instead of a simple strict press, okay? Hopefully that helps. There was a few creative cues for you. Purse over the shoulder, you could change that on the season. Could be Santa's sack, could be the leprechaun's sack of gold, whatever for the season. An orbiting movement, it's going around the earth, or just a simple corkscrew movement so that they have a visual to look at. Let me know if you have any other questions. My email is estoney@lt.life.